George Raft was a man with a reputation in the criminal underworld. He was a trusted member of the mob, and his connections ran deep. George had been involved in various illegal activities over the years but always stayed out of trouble with the law. One day, George was approached by a group of men looking for his help. They were involved in a high-stakes poker game and needed someone with George's connections to help them win. George agreed to help and quickly set about putting together a team of players who he knew could get the job done. The game was tense, but George and his team came on top. The men who had hired George were thrilled with the outcome, and they rewarded him handsomely for his efforts. George's reputation as a connected guy in the mob grew stronger from that day forward. Over the years, George continued to work with various members of the mob, using his connections to help them get what they wanted. He was always careful to stay on the right side of the law, though, and he never got caught up in anything too dangerous.
Where's Hank? Did he come with you? It was funny the way I got caught at Smiley's. All the time I was working there, I was never picked up. So tonight I was only in there for a couple of minutes talking to the girls, and all of a sudden the place was full of cops. I tried to tell them I wasn't working there, but you know how cops are.
So you couldn't stand the smell of fresh air. You had to crawl right back in that sewer, didn't you? And I suppose you did it every time Hank's back was turned.
Johnny.
Oh, don't turn on the waterworks, man. It don't register.
Johnny, I wasn't working there.
I had you tagged right from the first time I saw you. A nickel and dime dame out to pick up a free ride.
You've got no right to.
And that line you dished out about being in love with me. Sister, you really had me thinking about you. Worrying about the way I treated you. I should have known better.
I meant it. Every word of it.
You forgot your suitcase.
Thanks.
What's this for?
I was walking out. I was heading for Chicago.
A guy can pick up a mongrel and feed him and give him a place to sleep and he'll stick. But not you.
No. Not me. All right, go on. Hit me again if that makes you feel any better. I've been hit before and harder.
There wasn't anything the way you're going to be smacked if I ever catch you out of line again. You're going to Hank like he asked you.
No, I'm not.
Oh, yes, you are. And we're going to forget all about tonight. Hank's never going to know anything about it. You just missed the early bus, you understand?
Johnny, what satisfaction can you get out of seeing me caged up with Hank?
You're married to him, ain't you? Well, that's where a wife belongs, with a husband, and that's where you're going.
For a change, I'm going to do what I want to.
I'm not asking you what you're going to do, sister. I'm telling you.
Ultimately, George's reputation as a connected guy to the mob served him well. Many respected and feared him, and he lived a long and prosperous life thanks to his criminal connections. One day, his fellow actors, James Cagney and Gary Cooper, found themselves in a dangerous situation with the mob. They had borrowed a large sum of money from a notorious mobster but could not pay it back on time. The mobster was furious and threatened to harm James and Gary if they didn't pay up. They turned to George for help, knowing he had connections with the mob. George was torn between his loyalty to his friends and his loyalty to the mob. He knew that if he helped James and Gary, he would go against the mob, which could have serious consequences. After much deliberation, George decided to call off the mob. He used his influence to convince the mobster to forgive the debt and let James and Gary off the hook. The mobster was initially hesitant but eventually agreed, knowing that George's connections could be helpful too. James and Gary were relieved and grateful to George for his intervention. They knew that they owed him their lives. From that day forward, they promised never to get involved with the mob again. Despite risking his reputation and safety, George knew he had made the right decision. He valued his friendship with James and Gary more than his connection with the mob. He continued to work in Hollywood and became even more respected for his loyalty and integrity.